Welcome to News and Views. I'm John Banville. Our guest this week is Senator Carl Marcellino. Senator Marcellino, thank you very much for being here.
I'm glad I'm here, John.
One of the biggest topics being discussed in Albany these days is an issue called the Common Core curriculum, and it's upsetting parents across our state. You recently held a Senate Education Committee hearing regarding the Common Core curriculum. And you made a statement. I'd like to show our viewers at home what you had to say at this, and then bring you back and discuss the importance of this issue.
Sure. You talk about delaying. I think there is no doubt in anybody's mind that the rollout of the Common Core is flawed, to say the least. There are problems all over the state. There are problems in districts all over the state. Well-performing districts, not well-performing districts, difficulties everywhere. So when we talk about a delay, and what Senator LaValle was getting at, we mean a delay. Give them time to get their acts together. Many districts simply have not gotten everything they need to their teachers. Many teachers have not been prepared to implement the Common Core standards or the Common Core curricula that is required in order to do this thing. And they're nervous, they're concerned, and they're passing that on through the children to the parents.
Senator Marcellino, I'm very glad that we have you on this program to discuss this issue, because you bring experience that not many legislators have. You were a teacher for 20 years in the New York City school system. And most importantly, I think that you have a sensitivity, particularly to students and what they need in order to succeed. Senator Marcellino, can you tell us a little bit about this Common Core curriculum and the effects it's going to have on our students, and your opinion on how we should proceed as a state?
I can't predict the future on this, John. I can tell you the effect that it's having on the students and the effect that it's having on the teachers who have to implement this program. There's a lot of stress being placed on these people. The Common Core was adopted in 2010. It is part of Race to the Top and No Child Left Behind and all this stuff that came out of the federal government. There's testing requirements to implement it. The districts are employing their own testing. The feds employ, they require at least two tests. The districts have pre-tests and post-tests. So the kids are getting tested to death. In some cases, one parent said over 6 days, his third grader got 12 hours worth of testing. The Bar Association, I believe, is only 9 hours for their exam. The SATs are 5 hours and thereabouts. So we're putting these kids under tremendous stress, and I don't understand the reasoning behind it, and I'm not quite sure of the outcome that's there, because part of this is the teachers will be evaluated based on the performance of the kids relative to their performance and how they're rated for, you know, continuation in their jobs. They're rightfully nervous about that. Many of them feel that they have not been given enough time to prepare, and this is my key. This is what I'm concerned about. This rush to bring the Common Core in has not been applied evenly throughout the state. Some districts took it in 2010 and ran with it. Some districts did not. Some districts thought it wasn't going to go anywhere, that it was just another change that state ed had promulgated, and they had plenty of time and there was no particular rush. So they didn't do it. The state ed promised them certain modules that they would be given, i.e., you know, demonstration lessons and so forth, using the Common Core procedures. The Common Core is not a set of facts. It's a methodology of teaching. That's what it's all about. It's not learning the multiplication tables, learning something else. It's how you teach math, how you approach reading comprehension, how you teach history. It's not history itself. It's how you bring it to the kid and how the kid can absorb it better. It wants to elevate their learning capability, elevate their reasoning capability, so that they're better able to compete in a global economy. Now, this is not a bad thing. This is a good idea. We need to do that. We always need to improve standards. As an educator myself, 20 years of teaching, my wife, a dean at a university, Adelphi University on the island. We're an education family. We believe in it. To do education correctly, you have to keep standards up and have to always keep reviewing and reevaluating your standards so you know what you're doing and if you're doing it correctly. Teachers have no problem with that. Administrators have no problem with that. I've talked to all the superintendents that I represent and many others. I've talked to many, many teachers over this last several years. And they're not fearful of standards. They're not fearful of being evaluated. That happens all the time. I was evaluated for 20 years. It happens. That's what the job is all about. But what they are concerned about is that they're going to be held to a standard that they haven't had a chance to get used to, that the kids haven't had a chance to get used to. One of the problems is the Regents exams that are coming. Now, Regents exams in this state are required for graduation and for diploma purposes. Well, there's a move to change the questions that the Regents would have to use Common Core techniques. Well, these are youngsters just having the Common Core maybe a year at most, staff only having the ability to be with these kids and to give them the training for about a year. That's not adequate time. This is a new way of teaching. This is a new way of absorbing information and applying it going forward. There's a lot of reading involved. Kids have to get used to reading it again. Well, you know, it's not bubble tests. The answers may be bubbled in, but it's a reading comprehension type format, which means you've got a paragraph to read, you've got to read it, maybe more than a paragraph. In some cases, I'm told it's more than one page that they have to read and then go back and answer questions based on that. That's not new, but the application is new. So if you're going to put these on Regents exams, now you have a real problem. Currently, the Common Core deals with some diagnostic testing, which shows how far you're moving in this program. No real impact on the child as such, or the child's future employment, or the child's future college degree, or even the high school diploma. And the last round of tests that were given, most districts did terribly on. They dropped like a rock. I mean, the numbers were poor everywhere. I mean, really poor. So there's a lot of concern now amongst the parents who saw this. Their youngsters have been performing very well all of a sudden. A big drop in math scores, a big drop in reading comprehension scores. Now, state ed said, well, we anticipated that. Well, that's all well and good, but the parents didn't. They didn't anticipate it because no one told them that. Yeah, Dr. King had made a comment, yes, he felt that would go down. But no, we took that seriously. That's, you know, that sounded like he was just, you know, backing everybody off and letting it happen, but they were really going to do well. Well, they didn't, and parents got rightly upset. Now, if you put them on a Regents exam, where their graduation is now put at risk, where their future employment is now put at risk, where getting a diploma is put at risk. Johnny can't go to Harvard, Jane can't go to Bryn Mawr, or any other college that maybe they choose, because there's a failure on the record now in a Regents exam for which they were ill-equipped and ill-prepared. This isn't fair to the kid, this isn't fair to the teacher, it's not fair to the district, it's not fair to the parents, it simply is not a good idea. So I have suggested to Dr. King and to State Ed that they wait and they move ahead with Common Core, provide all the materials that they had promised to provide but still have not. Even to this day, as we are speaking right now, they have not provided all the school districts, all the materials that these districts were supposed to have gotten. This is not a good thing. And that has to stop. That has to change. They have to give them the time to do what they have to do. Now, state ed says, well, they don't have to take our stuff. Yeah, they do. Yeah, they do. They have to take it because they're doing something brand new, and these are guidelines, and they want to use the guidelines. The teachers are saying, you told us you'd give us something. We're willing to work. Give us the material, and then let us adapt it, apply it, and move forward with the kids. A year isn't good enough. You can't snap your fingers and expect to get results like that. These are human beings. These are not widgets. They're not automatons. They have to learn. There's all kinds of problems. Johnny gets a headache the night before, misses a couple of days of class, is a little bit behind. Things happen, in other words. You know, it's not like an assembly line that you can just knock them off and push them out. At the end, everybody's the same. They're not. They're people. Everybody's different. Some have better learning skills. Some have better reading skills. Some have foreign language problems that they have to adapt to. They're not, English is not their first language. Got to give them time to figure it out and learn. Some are special education children where they're challenged mentally. They have a problem. Under the Common Core standards, they're tested and evaluated at their chronological level. Not their actual competence grade level, but their chronological level. In other words, if a child is old enough to be a freshman in high school, but their reading capability may be fifth grade, they're being tested as a freshman in high school. That's guaranteed failure. They're not going to pass. Everybody knows that. If you test them at the grade level that they have accomplished, that we all know they're at, well, then you get a chance to see how well they're adapting to the Common Core with their skill set. That's the fair way to do it. Not testing out of something that's like testing a kindergarten kid with college level work. It's not going to work. You know the kid can't do the work. So why go there? Why put the kid under stress? Put them where they know the kid takes, opens the book, opens the test pamphlet, starts reading the questions, realizes immediately this is way beyond me, way beyond. And now you've got a kid nervous, scared. Am I going to get yelled at? Is mommy going to yell at me? Is papa going to yell at me? Is my teacher going to be upset with me? I'm going to fail. Is it going to hurt me? What's going to happen? They don't want to fail. They want to do well. But if you set them up for failure, which you would do if you don't test them at the right level, you know, now some special ed people say, well, no, that's pigeonholing the kid. You got to move them up. You got to push them as hard as you can. But that's not the point here. That's not the point here. If they're capable of learning at a certain level, let's see if they've learned that level. If you want to move them further, that's fine, but deal with the level that they're supposed to be at or that they in fact are at. We don't want to hold them down. If they can move higher, fine, move them higher. But don't try to test someone at a grade level that they're not capable of performing at. Through no fault of their own, they're just not capable. That kindergarten kid cannot read at a high school level. We know that. Testing them at a high school level is only guaranteed failure. It's not holding them back. It's only guaranteeing they're going to fail and building up their frustration level, making school less than fun. Now, you know, school should be an interesting place to go. There should be fun involved in school. We all understand that. But it's work. It's hard work. You know, nobody's, you know, I don't know too many kids are going to say, yay, I'd rather go to school than go to the park and play, you know. That's there are some, obviously, but most, no. So why make it worse? Why really make it worse? Why make it painful for the kids? There's stories all over the place where kids are throwing up, the kids are nervous, they're scared, they don't want to wake up, they don't want to go home. They're coming to trauma. Parents are getting nervous because they have to deal with it. And the parents are frustrated because they can't even help the kid.
Right.
You know, it's like parents when the new math came in. All the standards were changed, all the methodology was changed. So right away, mommy couldn't help, nor could daddy help the kid with his math homework because they didn't know what they were doing. They didn't know the procedure. They didn't know what the new math meant. Well, it took a while to get used to the quote-unquote new math. Once that was accomplished, everything went fine. And I think the same thing will happen with the Common Core. Once you give them a chance to understand it, teachers, develop the skills, develop the strategies, develop the lesson plans, develop the procedures that they will use in the classroom, the techniques that they will use in the classroom to employ the Common Core with the children, to engage the children in a lesson that they will understand and learn from. The kids need time to learn. That can't happen overnight. So I've introduced legislation, as I said earlier, to make sure that no child will take a Common Core Regents exam, in other words, a Regents exam based on Common Core questioning, prior to this year's third grade group, this year's third grade, in other words, the class of 2023. That will give them time under Common Core. They're learning Common Core now. They're being taught with that technique now. Let them move through the system. Let them move through the procedures as well as the classes behind them. And move them through classes moving forward. They'll be taught with Common Core as well, but the Regents exams will be standard, the normal questioning. Now, if the Common Core is all it's jacked up to be, they should do even better with the old exams. You know, they should do even better. The new kids coming through won't impact Common Core questions until they reach the eighth grade. So from the third grade to the eighth grade, there's time for the kid to learn. That's all. We want them to develop the skill sets. We want the teachers to have this, to have the time to properly prepare the kids. And then if you're going to evaluate them on this program, at least it's fairly done. Everybody has a fair shot, as opposed to being unfairly said, well, the kids have had it for a year, now we're going to test them as if they've had it forever. Bad idea.
Senator Marcellino, that's all the time we have for this week. I'd like to bring you back on future shows as this piece of legislation that is going to affect every student in our state.
Yes, it will.
Makes it through the legislative process. I want to thank you very much for your time.
Thank you.
And we'll see you
good
soon.
Good to see you.